This fridge, it says Smeg on it. It's got two fridge doors and two freezer doors. And the fridge, I've disassembled it now, but it's got an internal cold plate. There's the drain for it. There's a little fan motor there. And the freezer I've disassembled, but there's two separate coils there. Each one has got its own coil with a defrost element and a fan motor on each side. Now this fridge has got two capillaries and it's got a solenoid valve between the two capillaries, which is controlled by the electronic PC board. And this fridge has developed an internal leak. We did a pressure test on it and the gas is leaking somewhere on the internal cold plate. Now you can't get to the internal cold plate to replace it, but I can put an external cold plate on. But now this cold plate is linked to the two capillaries that run the freezer. So if we're going to put a cold plate in there, the system, the way it is, will not work anymore. If you want to have a look behind it, I've just cut it open here a bit and I got to the two capillaries. There's one and the second one goes in here, and this is the solenoid valve, which I've disconnected now, but the solenoid works the two capillaries. Now what I'm planning to do is to put a cold plate in here and I'll bring the pipes out here and link it. So we'll first freeze the one coil, then the second coil, and then a cold plate. The operating system I'm going to do, just reach, where did I put the timer? I'm putting a defrost timer in and a double door thermostat. And this double door thermostat I'm going to mount onto the cold plate. And this will switch the compressor on and off. And this is a defrost timer, which will put both coils on defrost at the same time. And both of them will freeze at the same time. And I'm going to run a single capillary, so we won't use that solenoid anymore. Now this thing has got a fan down there. It's got a fan in the fridge and two fans for the two freezers. So there's four fans. So what I've done is the four fans, I've connected them up onto the thermostat with the compressor. So when the compressor runs, all four fans turns. When the compressor cycles on the thermostat, all four fans in the compressor stops. And when it goes on defrost, it cuts the power to the thermostat, so all four fans in the compressor stops while it's on defrost. But I've left the PC board in there because the PC board controls the low voltage for the light bulbs. Let me just turn it. Just switch it on. So the display still works because I'm running the display to the PC board, and all the buttons, if you push them, it plays music and it does things. So that still works, but it won't control the temperature. And it's got all these LED lights that work off a low voltage from the PC board, and the fan motor is 220, works through the thermostat and the defrost timer. So I haven't put the cold plate in yet. The cold plate will come another day and I'll show when I install it. And I'm busy converting this Smeg to a different type of operating system. This is the cold plate I'm going to use. Comes with two tubes, copper to aluminium, and those are the two holes that I made for the pipes. I've mounted the cold plate. The two pipes go through the two holes I've made. I've made a little bracket here and the thermostat on the roof. I made a little hole through and I've mounted the thermostat bulb. And this is the cold plate, the way I've mounted it in the fridge section. There's going to be a cover that goes over this so we won't see it. Normally I try and get the cold plate as high as possible. Purely because, same as hot air rises, cold air goes down, so you don't get much cold air on top. But because there's a fan motor here, it will circulate the air. So I just mounted it where it looked the best. This is behind the fridge. That is where the two tubes come out from the cold plate. I've cut a little slit into the metal, and the one tube from the cold plate goes straight down, connect to the compressor. I've wrapped a new capillary around a suction, and a new capillary goes onto the existing capillary into the one coil of the freezer. From the freezer there's a bridge back to the second coil, which is behind there. And then this aluminium tube here, I did an aluminium to aluminium weld onto a joint piece that joins to copper, which the joint is behind there, which goes back up to the cold plate. So before I close this all up, I'm just gonna do some leak tests, and then I'll fill this up and put the existing metal back there. The suction that came out the bottom, I've just chopped that off. The two capillaries are off, and I've put a new pencil dryer on there. So far, so good. This is the back of the fridge. That's where the suction runs in. I've just filled it in with polyfoam and put some aluminium foil tape on it. This is the back bit where I did all the joints. Filled it in with polyfoam and sealed it there with foil tape. And a new suction comes out there, and I've linked it up to the compressor with a new capillary. This is the drain pipe from the fridge side. I haven't put it into this tray yet. So this is what the back of the fridge will look like now. This is the top of the fridge where the PC board is. This is the thermostat that I've put in, and I made a little hole there where the bulb goes through onto the cold plate. And this is the defrost timer. Now, this thing has got this cover that covers it. Now, once I'm happy with the thermostat adjustment and everything else, I'll just mount everything inside this cover and close this cover up. So from the outside, you won't notice any of these. This is the Smeg fridge once I've completed it. I've put some thermometers in here. This one, minus 17. Minus 14, and the fridge is on 4.4. The display works, but it's not linked to anything. And inside the freezer, I've put all the covers together. There's a little ice maker and some shelves. This one, I've put some of the trays in. I'm still figure out where the rest of the trays fit. And the fridge 4.3, I had it down to 2 degrees just now, and I turned on the thermostat and it cycled. But I've put the cover back, so the cold plate is completely hidden. You don't see the cold plate behind there. And everything on it works, the defrost works. So all I'm gonna do is just set the thermostat, maybe run it for another 5 minutes or so, set the thermostat to cycle at about 3 degrees. There's gone up to 5 now from opening the door. And then we close the thermostat up in the top. And from the front, inside, or the top, you won't know that I've modified this whole system.